Assalamu alaikum, dear students. May Almighty give us peace, abundant blessings, wisdom, internal peace of mind, good health and prosperity, and everlasting happiness. With the bounteous blessings of Almighty, we shall begin our today's session. I welcome you all to our English video session. Today we are going to learn an interesting supplementary lesson, A Shot in the Dark, written by Hector Hugh Munro. So what is the title of the lesson? A Shot in the Dark, written by Saki. So to begin with the intro of the writer, Hector Hugh Munro was a British writer. He was born on 18th December 1870 in Burma. His first book, The Rise of the Russian Empire, was published in 1900, and his second book, The Westminster Alice, in the year 1902. He wrote under the pen name Saki. So Hector Hugh Munro wrote under the pen name Saki. He published 138 short stories, 5 plays, 2 novels and dozens of political essays. He is considered as a master of short story and often compared to the great writer O. Henry. He wrote a full-length play titled The Washed Pot in collaboration with Charles Maud. So today we are going to learn an interesting lesson, A Shot in the Dark. What's the title of the lesson? A Shot in the Dark, written by Saki. So before proceeding to the lesson, one should know the meaning of the title, A Shot in the Dark. So for example, if you are seeing a person for the first time, you doesn't have any knowledge about the person. That is, you don't know anything about the person. But you guess that this person might be a very rude personality. So he might be a very cruel person. So you guess seeing the appearance. So in life, we always make a mistake that appearance is deceptive. So whatever we see, which is not the exact truth in our life. So seeing is not believing. But in this lesson, seeing is believing, which has been disproved. So, a shot in the dark is nothing but for the first time, you are seeing the person and you are guessing. That is, you doesn't have any knowledge about the person, but still you guess. This person might be of this character. That guess might not be correct. So, that is a shot in the dark. So, coming to the lesson, A Shot in the Dark is an amusing story. So, it's an interesting story, a very humorous story that describes how a man who considered himself very smart and clever. So, in this lesson, one person considers himself as very smart and clever, but actually, he had mistaken the genuine person named Bertie. So, it points out that sometimes truth is misinterpreted and people who think they are wise are not always right. The feelings and the actions of fellow human beings have to be trusted and given due respect. Now we shall discuss the important characters in the story. There are 4 characters in the story. First one is Phillips Leatherby, a person who wants to become a politician. Next is Mrs. Salpingago, a rich and an influential lady of high rank. Then Bertie is the son of Mrs. Salpingago. And fourth character is Claude People Casey, a friend of Leatherby. So, let me recall, who are the characters? Phillips Leatherby, the person who wants to become a politician. Mrs. Salpingago, she is a rich and a great lady of high rank. Bertie is the son of Mrs. Salpingago. Claude People Casey is a friend of Leatherby. So look at this picture, Phillips Leatherby, Bertie, and the center, the lady is Salpingago. So look at this picture, you can see Claude People Casey, Phillips Leatherby, and Bertie, and Salpingago, and 2 symbols you can see, Demi Lion and Greyhound Current Crest. So what is a crest? Crest is nothing but a symbol representing a family, which we will discuss in the of following slides. the Dark, written by Saki. Once again, we'll discuss the important characters in the story. First one is Philip Slitherby. He's a person who wants to become a politician. Second character is Mrs. Salpan Jago. She is a rich and influential lady, that is a powerful lady of social importance. Bertie is the son of Mrs. Salpan Jago. And the fourth character is Claude People Casey. So these are the characters in the story. The story begins with Philip Slitherby, who is comfortably seated in a railway compartment, that is railway carriage, and the compartment seems to be empty. So he has planned to visit Mrs. Salpan Jago to Brill Manor. So where is the place he is going to? He is going to Brill Manor, which is the residence of his new friend Mrs. Salpan Jago. So Mrs. Salpan Jago, she is a rich and an influential lady, that is a powerful lady of high rank. That is, she had some social importance in London and in the country of Cheshire. Cheshire is a place in England. So she is a great and an influential person both in London and England. So why Philip Slitherby is going to meet Mrs. Salpan Jago? Philip Slitherby's personal interests want to become a politician, and especially he wanted to become a politician in Cheshire, that is the eastern division of Cheshire. He wanted to become a politician. So it is not that an easy task to become a politician in Cheshire. So under the influence of some person only he can become a politician. So he wants to meet Mrs. Salpan Jago. As he knows, she is a rich and influential lady. With the help of her, he can easily become a politician. That is, he can acquire a political position in Cheshire. So he is going to meet Mrs. Salpan Jago. This is the reason. That is, he wants to become a politician. And at the same time, he wants to get the influence of somebody. And he hears that Mrs. Salpan Jago, she is a rich and influential lady. So he wants to seek help from her. Slitherby had been delighted to meet her at a small and a friendly luncheon party. So they met at a small party. He was more pleased when Mrs. Salpan Jago asked him to stay in her country house from Friday to Tuesday. So what happens? So there is a meeting. That is, they meet. Who meets? Philip Slitherby and Mrs. Salpan Jago. They meet in a small party, and he is very happy. Who is very happy? Philip Slitherby is very happy because Mrs. Salpan Jago asked him, that is requested him, to stay in her house from Friday to Tuesday. Some of the passengers were waiting on the platform. So Slitherby found his club acquaintance. So what happens now? He is thinking of all the past happenings. That is, he was seated in a railway compartment. So the passengers were waiting on the platform. Suddenly Slitherby, he found a club acquaintance. That is, a friend. He sees a friend. So he calls the friend for window chatting. So the friend is coming. And they have a good chat. The club acquaintance is nothing but the person that you have met, but you don't know anything about that person. That is called club acquaintance. So the club acquaintance inquired him that if he is staying with Mrs. Salpan Jago for the weekend. So that particular friend is asking whether he is going to stay with Mrs. Salpan Jago for the weekend. And he assured that he is going to have a good time because she is an excellent lady. As they had the conversation, the train started moving. He bids goodbye. Who bids goodbye? The club acquaintance. The club acquaintance is nothing but his friend. So Slitherby, after bidding goodbye to his friend, he pulled up the window and he started reading the magazine lying on his lap. So what happened? The train moved. He started reading the newspaper. Suddenly, he heard somebody shouting. His traveling companion was a young man of 22 years. So the person who traveled with Slitherby was a young person, 22 years old, and he had dark hair, fair complexion, and he was dressed like a silly country person. And he was very angry and he was shouting to the extent. He was speaking to himself, he was cursing himself. What the hell is happening? Where I have lost all my purse, everything? He was shouting to him. Slitherby could see the following things: that a cigarette case, a matchbox, and railway ticket, a key, everything he pulled out of his bag. So the young man was very seriously searching something, so he pulled out all the things from the bag. What are the things? Cigarette case, matchbox, latch key, then silver pencil case, railway ticket, etc. Everything he pulled outside from his bag. Still he was searching something. The thing which he wanted was not able to find. He was cursing himself loudly. So Slitherby was not at all disturbed by this. He started glancing the magazine. The young man started speaking to Slitherby, saying that he heard him saying that he is going to meet Mrs. Salpingago at Brill Manor. So what happened? The young man, he started speaking to Slitherby, was glancing the newspaper, and he said that he has heard the conversation with his friend, that is club acquaintance, that he is going to meet Mrs. Salpingago at Brill Manor. Mrs. Salpingago, she is my mother. Who says? The young man said that Mrs. Salpingago is my mother and I am the second son of Mrs. Salpingago. So Salpingago is his mother and he would be coming there on Monday evening to Brill Manor. He said that Monday evening he will be coming there, so we shall meet there in Brill Manor. He said that he had not seen his mother for 6 months. Who says? Bertie says that he had not seen his mother for 6 months because he had been in traveling all the time. He introduced himself as Bertie. What is the name of the young person? Bertie, B-E-R-T-I-E, Bertie, and is the second son of Salpin. He used to travel to different places, so it had been 6 months to meet his mother. So for past 6 months he had not seen his mother because he had been on traveling. Slitherby asked Bertie if he had lost something. So now he started asking whether he had lost something. He replied that he had left the purse with the 4 quid, Q-U-I-D. Quid is nothing but British currency. So he has lost his purse and he had 4 quid in it, and which is considered to be the most important wealth for him. The purse was in his pocket just before he was starting, but later he wanted to post a letter, so by mistake he would have kept it on the table. He said that by mistake I would have kept it on the table, but I had some money which I had paid for taxi and ticket. Now I got only 6 pence, which is not sufficient for me to travel further. So I'm going to get down near Bronke. So I'm going to stay in a inn for 3 days fishing. So I'm going for 3 days fishing. I'm going to get down near Bronke. B-R-O-N-D-Q-U-A-Y. So these are the small places. Okay, small places in England. And now he is in need of money. So he requests Slitherby to lend him £2, £10 or £3. So who is requesting? Now Bertie is requesting Slitherby to lend him £2, £10 or £3. Some money so that he can travel further. So after a moment's hesitation, Slitherby agreed to give that amount. First Slitherby hesitated, later he agreed, okay, I'll give the money. Bertie thanked him that he was lucky to come across one of his mother's friend. And he added that it's a great lesson for him not to leave the purse anywhere, even by mistake. And the purse which has a crest in it, he says that, who says? Bertie says that, my purse which contains a crest. What is a crest? It is a symbol representing the family. Slather, I asked Bertie what was his crest. I said a crest is a symbol which representing the family. So Bertie said that it was demi lion holding a cross crosslet in its paw. Demi is half. So image of lion in not fully the half image of a lion and the paw of lion there is a cross symbol. Suddenly Slatherby said that when his mother wrote to him giving him a list of trains she had a greyhound current on her notepaper. That is current is nothing but the image of a animal in the running form. So hound is a dog. So mother used some other symbol, that is a symbol of a dog in the running form. So there started a confusion in Slatherby's mind regarding the crest. The young man said that the family has the right to use both the crest, that is demi lion holding a cross crosslet in its paw and a greyhound current, C-O-U-R-A-N-T, H-O-U-N-D, hound. So they have the rights to use both, but he always uses the demi lion. So suddenly the young man started packing his fishing equipments because he has to get down in the next station. And suddenly Slatherby said that he had never met his mother, but they have corresponded several times. Bertie says that she was supposed to be exactly like him and she has the same dark brown hair. So the young man now gets down at the station and asks Slatherby about the money which he has promised to give. Slatherby replied that he is not willing to give him the money because there are many confusions regarding the appearance of his mother. What Bertie says? Bertie says that she has a dark brown hair, but Slatherby had met Salpanjago in a luncheon party on Monday and she was a blonde. That is, she had a pale yellow hair. So there are many confusions regarding the appearance of his mother and the symbol which they use. So he hesitated. That is, he denied to give money to Bertie. Slatherby thought himself to be a very clever person. So Bertie had cheated him and he found out the culprit regarding the appearance of Salpanjago and the crest. When his train came to his destination, he was greeted in a dignified manner. So the train, that is, he was about to board and he was suddenly greeted by a tall man called Claude People Casey, who had traveled down by the same train. Suddenly they both seem to start their chatting and he sees a car waiting for him. Who sees? Slatherby sees a car waiting for him. He noticed the door panel. That is, in the door panel, he could see the two crest, that is a greyhound current and a demi lion holding a cross crosslet in its paw. Claude People Casey was a noisy person. So far, he was discussing about the political gossips and personal stories, anecdotes, etc. Casey remarked Slatherby that Salpanjago is a very brilliant woman. She is a very clear thinker. But recently she had made a stupid thing in her appearance. Slatherby eagerly asked what was the change. Casey told that she used to have a beautiful dark brown hair and fair complexion. But suddenly she appeared as a blonde and she spoiled her looks. Slatherby learned that Mrs. Salpanjago had changed her dark brown to blonde just 5 weeks ago. But Bertie had seen her mother 6 months before. This was the reason for the confusion. So she became blonde just 5 weeks ago. So thus the story ends. Finally, he realized that Bertie had not lied to him, but he had mistaken him as a fraud. So seeing is believing, which has been disproved in this story.